Hello guys, in this video we will learn about the ping. What is ping, right? So ping is generally an internet program which is used to check whether any two IP addresses are connected in a network or not, right? So basically, suppose this is a source and this is a destination. You can also consider this as that whether this destination computer is connected to this source computer or not, right? So how to check? So for that, there is a program which is called a ping, packet internet grouper. What it does, basically, ping generally sends a command through ICMP, that is Internet Control Message Protocol, which will go throughout the connected system and check whether there is the destination IP or not. For example, this source computer is this one, which have IP address 10.0.0.7. It is IP address of this source computer. And suppose this is a destination computer and the IP address of this destination computer is 10.0.0.15, right? Now we have to check whether the computer 1 is connected to computer 2 or not. So how we will check whether they are both connected or not? So for that, there is a command ping. How to check? Type run into the search, then type CMD. So your command prompt will be open. Then type the command /ping t. Here you have to type the IP address of the destination, means 10.0.0.15. It is the IP address of destination computer which you want to check whether it is connected to a network or not. Now after giving this command, ARP request protocol will be go through ICMP, right? Now it will check throughout all the system and it is currently in waiting state. It is waiting for the reply from the destination that it is connecting or not, right? So suppose command is reaching here. Now up to that, if IP address is matched to this source, this destination computer, it will give reply to the source that it is connected, right? So basically, what is this procedure? It is a procedure of troubleshooting. It's a procedure of troubleshooting. We are troubleshooting to computers that whether they are connected or not. So basically, what it will give to us? It will give two things to us. A response time. Response time is the response time from which source to destination information has gone and the reply has to come. So the total response time between source and destination we can get by command ping. And we can also troubleshoot any computer in network that whether the two systems are connected or not, or whether two IP addresses are connected or not, right? So this thing can be given us via ping command, right? Now you can see here it is ARP request protocol in which first source MAC address is there. Source MAC address, it is a unique address, means it is the address of, it is the physical address of the computer 1. Then destination MAC address, it is the physical address of computer 2. Then source IP. Source IP means the IP address of computer 1 through which we are troubleshooting the network computer, and destination IP is IP address of the second computer through which we are checking that whether this source destination IP is present into our network or not. If it is present, what is the response time and is it connected in a group or not, right? So these things can be given to us via ping command, right? ARP reply is unicast. ARP reply which we are seeing for getting, that is unit cost, means it only contains destination MAC address in that, right? Now if we talk about whenever a computer is not assigned any IP address, right? Suppose any computer system is there and which is not assigned any IP address and it still wants to check whether the computer is connected to LAN cable or not, right? Suppose any computer system is there and we have not assigned any IP address to that computer and we still want to check that whether it is connected to whole network or not. So what we will do in that case, we will use loopback address, right? What is loopback address? We will see loopback address in detail now, right? Basically, here is a system, it is a connected network system in which P1 and P2 are suppose those two systems, and suppose P1 is not assigned any kind of IP address and it wants to check whether it is connected to the network or not. So for that, loopback address is in the concept. So let's see the loopback address. Loopback address also used as always used destination address, right? So suppose this is a source IP and it want to check whether it is connected into the network or not, right? So we will place our loopback destination address into loopback address into the destination IP, right? So we used 127 series for loopback address purpose, right? 127.0.0.1, it is 127 series which we are using for loopback address. And suppose we want to check whether this P1 is connected into the network system or not. So for that, what we will do, we will place basically this source, it is not assigned any IP, that's why we have put this 0.0.0.0 default IP, and here destination IP. In the destination IP we have put loopback address. Why it is used? To check whether any system which is not assigned any IP is connected to the network or not, right? So it is used as inter-process communication, but both processes should be in same system. Both processes should be in same system, right? Now it is the use that whenever we will pass the 127.0.0.1, this is loopback address, it will get to know us whether the system is connected to in a network or not. The methodology will be same, that you will open run that command prompt, then you will assign the loopback address via the ping command ping, then you will assign loopback address, and it loopback address will help you to check whether your system is connected to the network or not, right? Now what is the drawback of this loopback address? To just check a single system is connected to the whole network or not, your complete 127 series, complete 127 series of IP address is wasted, because 127.0.0.1, how many ports it contains, right? 255, 255, 255, right? So complete 127 series is wasted only due to check, we want to check that whether a system is connected to a given network or not, right? So it is the loopback address concept under ping command, right? So I hope you have understood the ping command very well. So further, if you have any kind of queries or doubts, you can ask us and we will try to solve your queries or doubts as early as possible. Thank you so much guys, have a nice day. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.
Hey there. Subscribe to my channel. And also press this bell icon. So you never miss any new updates, 'cause whenever we upload new video you will get a notification on your phone.